Okay, now we will see the third response, third example of response, the ramp or linear function. Let's see how its graph looks like. Consider our graph in which the x-axis is t and y-axis is some input variable which is function of time, x of t. Then for example at p is equal to 0, okay, initially the system is at rest, okay, we have not given any input to the system, particular input to the system. At time t is equal to 0, just the system has given an input in a linear increasing input, linearly it will increase, okay. For example, the x-axis interval, if you take this interval as t, and this input will have a magnitude of some, consider some alphabet A, okay. The linear input magnitude is considered as amplitude, which is referred to as amplitude, some alphabet A. If you see the function, how it looks like, x of t will have a two region, okay, two regions. The one region is this region which is below 0, time t is below 0. When time t is below 0, the function value is 0 obviously. So it is 0 when t is less than 0. And another possible set of variable is this region. Time is greater than or equal to 0, then we suddenly given an input of linear input which whose amplitude is denoted by alphabet capital A. This is valid when t is greater than or equal to 0. Consider, for example, if we consider some alphabet M, capital M, be the slope of this ramp function, slope of this linear function, then we can easily will know. For example, consider this is some initial starting point x, and this function will reach some maximum point, some y. Then if m is to be considered as the slope of this ramp function, then what is the slope? Slope is nothing but difference between the maximum value in the y-axis divided by difference between the maximum, slope is nothing but difference between the maximum and minimum value in the y-axis divided by difference between the maximum and minimum value in for x-axis. X-axis is nothing but slope. So here the difference between the maximum and difference between the maximum value and minimum value. Here we indicated this with A, which is, let's see, maximum value in the y-axis is y, and minimum value in the y-axis is y minus 10. So at the same time in the x-axis, the maximum value is a point P, and the minimum value is the initial point, which is 0. Indirectly, this can be written as m is equal to, so we have already considered some alphabet A as the magnitude of this linear function. So m is equal to A by y minus x is equal to simply A divided by some t. Okay, this is, we consider this slope as m is equal to A by T. This is a simple equation. Let's indicate this as equation 1. Then what is the value of function? X of T, as per our graph, we are only interested in this region. Means X of T is greater than or equal to 0 region. So X of T, when X of T is greater than or equal to 0, then our function value is A, just A. Okay? Then A is, according to equation 1, A is slope into time. This can be given equation 2. Then what is the value of f of or we have written here x. X input value, when we apply a Laplace transform to equation 2, then what is the Laplace transform of equation 2? L of x of t is equal to, we have to put in the integral form of Laplace transform, which is given as x of t e power minus st into dt. Okay, if you put this our function value in this equation, what we will get? Our function value is, so our Laplace transform is x of s is equal to integral 0 to infinity. From equation 2, we can write our function value as a into e power minus st into dt. Then in terms of slope, we can write this equation as integral 0 to infinity. Instead of writing a, we can write a is equal to m into t. According to our equation 2, we can write a is equal to m into t. Now e power minus st into dt. Therefore, this is our Laplace transform formula according to our present input. Okay. Now we have to integrate this variable m. So m is what we call, m is constant, slope is already constant. So can we can take it outside of the integral 0 to infinity t power minus e power s t into e power minus s t into dt. So we have to integrate this equation first. Okay. So x of f is equal to, let's this equation be given a number, equation 3. Then we have to integrate this equation. Now what we have to do? We have to use integration by part. Integration by part. Okay, I assume you already used your intermediate or plus two classes, the intermediate by parts. So equation 3 will just looks like integral u into dv. Then according to integration by parts, the solution for this equation is u into v minus integral of v du. Okay, let's give this as equation 4. Okay, now compare the equations. Okay, compare equation 4 and 3. Then write down the variables. According, when we compare these two equations, we can say that u is equal to p, and what about dv? Dv is equal to nothing but e power minus st into dt. Okay, then from when we apply a derivative to u, what will happen? Du is equal to, just it is a dt. Let's say this equation is equation 5. Then what about from dv? Dv is equal to e power minus st into dt. Then we have to find the v from this equation. So both sides apply integral. Okay, derivative integral will be cancelled. V is equal to integral e power minus st into dt is equal to e power minus st. It is in the form of integral e power minus at. So the integration for this is e power minus st divided by minus s. Okay, let's say this is equation 6. Then now substitute equation 5 and 6 in equation 4. Now what we will have? From equation 4, integral u into dv is equal to whose solution is u into v minus integral v du. So implies, so u is p and dv is, according to our equation 6, it is e power minus st divided by minus, yes, minus integral v du. Our v, according to similarly equation, the first part of equation 6 is minus first part of the equation is e power minus st minus 1 by s e power minus st into dt. Over minus st into dt is our solution of integration by parts. Let's say this is equation 7.